My name is Kairan Quazi. I'm 14 years old. I just graduated from Santa Clara University with a degree in computer science and engineering. And this month, I'll be starting as a full-time software engineer in the Starlink engineering team at SpaceX. My interests are very multivariate, from reading the philosophical works of Hobbes and Nietzsche to the sci-fi works of Philip K. Dick. I play video games with friends, I play some sports, I play tennis and the piano, I used to do martial arts. I play a lot of different types of games, mainly first-person shooters and open-world games, but yeah, I would say my taste is pretty varied. I would say if there's anyone I look up to the most, it's my mom. She taught me to always be solution-oriented when faced with challenges. And I would say she's definitely the CEO of our household and has had the biggest impact on how I think about life. By third grade, it was, I think, very clear to my parents, my teachers, and my pediatrician that mainstream education wasn't the right path for me. I was tested by a team of neuropsychologists, and they determined that not just my intelligence, but also my emotional intelligence and executive functioning skills were at a level where they recommended that I begin university. And so I enrolled in Las Positas Community College at the age of 9, majoring in mathematics. I finished that degree in 2 years, so I got my associate's degree in mathematics, and then I transferred to Santa Clara University doing computer science and engineering, and I just graduated last month. I own several MSI products. I own an MSI Raider laptop. I have an MSI 1440p monitor, as well as a 3080 graphics card. I've been using the Raider for more than 3 years now, since the model's launch. Since then, I haven't had any technical issues outside of just like, replacing the paint on the keycap. I use a variety of software on my MSI laptop. For my software engineering, AI, and machine learning work, I primarily use PyCharm, C-Lion, and other JetBrains IDEs. I also use Jupyter Notebook, as well as graphics card-heavy AI workloads. I also use productivity tools, primarily for when I was in university for classes, as well as doing video editing, some of which was using Adobe Premiere, and others using homegrown software. The laptops were able to handle a majority of the workloads with ease. Obviously, for some very intensive AI workloads, you have to have server-grade cards, but it still was able to perform incredibly well on those. Especially for a laptop, the thermals were amazing when doing GPU-heavy tasks. The laptop chassis is incredibly well made. It's very durable for on the go. Even though the laptop is heavier and larger, it doesn't feel that way when carrying it around in a backpack or bag. And the keyboard, even though it's a membrane keyboard, it still feels incredible. And so those are the two features that I like the most on the laptop. I would say my MSI Raider laptop has been critical to my career pursuits. For all 4 years of university, I've used my MSI laptop exclusively for my machine learning internships. It allows me to train my machine learning models locally, which saves both development time and cost because I don't have to use a third-party service like Google Colab. And of course, having access to a powerful machine helped me with my personal AI projects where there wasn't a company funding something like a Google Colab service. After my first year at community college, I was looking for internships. I ended up putting together a list of tech companies and just cold calling them. And only one person responded, and even inside Intel, only one person, my former boss, Ms. Lama Nachman, I'm from the human AI team. And she was willing to meet with me for just 30 minutes to talk to me. I came in expecting it to just be more of like a, hey, you know, maybe in a few years. But we ended up talking for 90 minutes and I was offered an internship on the spot. And so then at the age of 10, I started with my first summer at Intel Labs. And I've been doing an academic year co-op with them since then for 4 years now. And I've been working on natural language processing work. We're working on the next generation of Dr. Stephen Hawking's communication system. It's an open source tool that allows people with motor neuron disabilities to communicate. So motor neuron disabilities are a class of diseases that degenerate the neurons across your body. And so, for example, Dr. Stephen Hawking could only move a cheek muscle. So our system was initially designed to use that sensor and be able to select through menus And then, although when it was open sourced, we added support for adding your own sensors so that people could use it for free. The project I'm working on is the next generation of that tool. We're extending it so that it can listen in automatically on conversations and generate full sentence personalized responses, which allow the user to communicate much faster and much more easily than the older versions of the system. And so that work is primarily doing natural language processing, indexing, as well as some audio work in diarization and transcription and voice activity detection. A lot of people, when I call them, didn't pick up or weren't very receptive to my idea. And I think while that was frustrating for me, my parents always instilled in me that you are where you are meant to be. And so after Intel, I think I really realized that that was where I was destined to be. And so nowadays I can just laugh it off because I had such an amazing experience at Intel. When I was looking for a full-time job after university, I applied to 100 companies. I believe I was rejected from 95 of them. Two offers were placed on freeze due to tech market. And then I finally got three offers, one of which was SpaceX. And while that was very demoralizing for me, having so many people in positions of influence viewing my age as a proxy for my ability and maturity. Once I landed at SpaceX, I really realized that that was the right company for me, from the culture to the technical work. And if I had gotten another position, I wouldn't have ended up finding that. And so now I'm really, I think, lucky that I had that experience, because it also taught me resilience and being able to just keep moving.